holding it close to my little chair, so I got to put it on my other camera, so I put it. But we're here, and then it's nothing.
Gareth, why are you sat on the floor? Drop my chair. Apparently I'm not using it. Okay, as long as you're okay, it's all right. This is intense, Bob, isn't it? A bit weight in between it all.
Welcome along to the press conference one more time. We've brought in the trainers as promised. So Tyson Fury's trainer, Sugar Hill Stewart, good to see you. And Deontay Wilder's trainer, Malik Scott. Malik, good to see you too. Malik, talk to me. Deontay says that you've been able to bring something out of him that nobody else had. Why is that?
I'm a student of the game, obviously. And so Deontay, in my opinion, he ruled the heavyweight division, had 10 defenses at that time, and was just using one weapon, and on certain occasions he'll use two or three. But over the years, being in training camp with him and boxing, I used to always say, when he get into a fight, a lot of those things disappear, and I just never understood why. It's because he got content with just knocking people out with one weapon, which was the right hand. What I did was I went to his toolbox. I didn't give him the toolbox. I went in and I pulled everything out that I feel as though that he'd do well. And I made sure we didn't do it from a subconscious state, or we didn't do it by accident. And the way to make sure it wasn't done from a subconscious state was constantly do it and drill it over and over and over again. And that's what I did. So it's not like I gave him a toolbox and I'm teaching him something new. Everything I'm teaching him, I may put it in different variations of things to have him throwing combinations. What I don't have Deontay Wilder doing is doing choreographic pad work. What I don't have Deontay Wilder doing is ducking down to the ground like he's fighting like Pernell Whitaker. He's fighting a tall guy. If a 6'7 guy is fighting a 6'7 guy, somebody has to get under a hook. I have tons of examples to prove this stuff. So it will say, some people were saying, but why do we have Deontay Wilder ducking under a hook? He's a tall guy. Yeah, he's fighting a taller guy too. I don't want my fighter just catching punches. Fury's a big man, small gloves. Catching punches is damaging too. I don't want my fighter just parrying punches. I want him to be able to slip punches, parry punches. And that's where the five different dimensions thing come from. Deontay Wilder can do it all. And I just pulled a lot of stuff out of him in training camp. And I made sure we drilled them with intent, not from a subconscious space.
I hear you. It's been looking great. Talk to me, Sugar Hill, because you moved into this relationship with Tyson Fury just before the second fight, right? Took over after that first fight and saw obvious opportunity to do something differently going into that second fight and switch up the approach from the first fight. What opportunity do you see going into this trilogy fight to do things differently, if any?
Well, training Tyson Fury has just been pretty much making him better. He's already been an exceptional boxer before I started training him. And just fine-tuning those skills, making sure he understands a little bit more things that maybe he didn't see, allowing him to see those things, but more importantly, just being ready. I feel like Tyson Fury being ready is unstoppable.
Malik and Deontay talk about each other as having a brotherly love relationship, right? What kind of, how would you describe, Tyson, your relationship with Sugar Hill? You got your mic.
Yeah, me and Sugar go back a long way, back to like 2010, Detroit City. We've got a great bond going on, and to have any successful relationship, you've got to have good communication. And that's the most important thing in our lives, communicating with each other. And me and Sugar Hill, I've got that. We have this bonding glue where we gel together. We've got similar personalities. It's not easy for me to pick a trainer because I do outlandish things. I'm outspoken. I do a lot of stuff. And I've got to almost have someone on the same wavelength and personality factor to match that in order to be able to train me. And I definitely found a match with Sugar Hill here.
Is he a lot to deal with, Sugar Hill?
No.
All right, fair enough. Deontay, it seems like trust was key for you when you were making the decision in terms of who you wanted to be the head guy in your corner. Where does that trust come from with Malik, and has he surprised you with everything else that he's been able to bring to the table for you?
I trust my brother with my life as he trusts me with his, you know. I give my shirt off my back as he would for me, you know, and that's how it's always been from the first connection. See, when we both first met, it was just, the energy was just, it was connection. You know, sometimes you can meet other humans and you just, your energies just, you just don't mix with each other. And then you can meet others that is just like, damn, where you been all my life? You know what I'm saying? And that's how it was with him. And fun fact, my birthday and his mother lands on the same day. His birthday and my mother's land on the same day. And when I met him, he brought his family along. We was in camp to see him. I cooked for them, the Southern hospitality. And we got to know each other even more. Even when we fought each other, it brought us even more closer, more so than ever. And in boxing, you need people that you can trust in this sport. I mean, this is a money-driven sport. There's so many loopholes and different things that can go in, and you just never know who may be jealous, who may envy you in certain ways. Even when you think the ones that really love you, or you have them at your dinner table with your children, and they play with your children, you know. And sometimes that's just not the case. But with him, you know, with all of his, all my guys, you know, I don't have a big entourage. I don't need so, you know. And it's just the love that we have for each other, all of us, that we have.
Come on, get a room.
So
get over with.
I think, Malik, one of the things that people have been super interested in is watching how much you've been working on fundamentals. And that's been something that you guys have talked about openly, right? I think people on the back of that really want to know, what does that mean for Deontay Wilder in terms of the way he approaches this fight? Does he come out aggressive? Quickish answer if you can, sorry.
Well, when it comes to working with Deontay fundamentals, it was easy because he have good fundamentals. It's just that a lot of times he didn't use them. So it goes back to the statement that I'm really just reminding him about so many different tools that he just wasn't using. And we wasn't going to do those things one time on one sparring partner good and then forget about it. No, we're fighting Tyson Fury. And fighting Tyson Fury, he's not just fighting Tyson Fury. I'm going against the intelligent great brain as far as Sugar Hill, because Sugar Hill come from the claw. So when I approach a fight like it's the opponent. Then it's the brain behind the opponent. And that's strong coming from over there. And what that did was it created a fervor, an anger kind of. So when I would do film study and I would have scheduled 10, 12 rounds of MS bar, I say, no, we're doing 16 rounds. I'm gonna stay up till 5 a.m. to do film study. I'm gonna call you at 2 in the morning to get you up. I'm gonna make sure Joey Scott is on you about, because I know who we're facing.
And knowing who you're facing and how he's likely gonna come out, do you start equally as aggressively? Is that the game plan?
The game plan is we have an answer for anything Tyson Fury do. Anything.
Tyson is obviously a very confident man, right? But we all know that Deontay Wilder is live in any fight. Do you have to work to keep his confidence at bay just to make sure that he keeps that in check, that Deontay is a dangerous opponent?
No, that wouldn't be true. Tyson Fury is very conscious of Deontay Wilder, his abilities, as well as myself being conscious of him. And it's just being sharp, it's just staying focused, and it's also just learning more. You know, there's always something to learn in boxing, and Tyson's taking that very well, and he's enjoying learning and having fun with it. So having fun and learning and executing and, trying to be the best, being perfect at what you do, that just makes for a better Tyson Fury. And I'm excited for this Saturday coming up, actually, to see what Deontay and Malik's been working on, my man Malik. And, I'm happy for him, and I want to see what they have. I mean, I know Malik for a while, and it's exciting. It's exciting to be in this position, going against Malik, and just seeing what we know, where we come from, and put it all to work on Saturday. It's exciting. I do believe in what they've been doing and what they've been working on. I've seen some of the clips, and it makes me more excited to get up and to get Tyson going even more,
for sure.
So much similar. And just expecting nothing but the same, but a knockout.
I appreciate hearing that respect. Thank you very much, Sugar Hill Stewart. Fantastic to have you with us. Malik Scott, also appreciate your time. Listen, we are going to go to a very short break. Both fighters, Tyson Fury and Deontay Wilder, will deliver their closing comments in just a minute. Stay with us. I'm assuming...
Yeah. Let's stop. Or no, I already know what you're doing.